Hello students, now let's start our new chapter, chapter 16, Electronic Payment System. The main concept you are going to learn in this chapter, Electronic Payment Systems, Classification of Electronic Payment Methods, Card-Based Payment Systems, Electronic Account Transfer, Electronic Cash Payment Systems, Mobile Banking and Internet Banking, Unified Payments Interface, Cash on Delivery. So first let us see about what is electronic payment system. What is the main purpose of electronic payment systems? Let us see that. Okay. Nowadays, money becomes the major medium of exchange. Every day, people buy or sell goods and services for money. For that, some payment systems were developed to facilitate the growth of commerce and economic development. Okay, let's see the definition of electronic payment system. An electronic payment system is a financial arrangement that consists of an intermediator to facilitate transfer of money substitute between a payer and a receiver. Sometimes it is also called as liquidation, clearing system or clearing service. It ensures the transfer of value from one subject of the economy to another and plays an important role in modern monetary systems. Okay. Next topic is classification of electronic payment methods. Based on the value of money transactions, processing time, processing requirements, security issues, and usability, electronic payment systems are generally classified into two types. What are they? Micro electronic payment systems and macro electronic payment system. What are the two classifications of electronic payment methods? Micro electronic payment systems and macro electronic payment systems. Okay, let us discuss them one by one. First, let us see about micro electronic payment systems. It is an online payment system designed to allow efficient and frequent payments of small amounts. If you want to do small amounts of transactions, you have to use micro electronic payment systems. Okay. In order to keep transaction cost very low, the communication and computational cost are minimized here. As the security of micro electronic payment system is comparatively low, it could be tampered. But the cost of fraud is much higher than the possible value to be gained by fraud itself. So, the security in micro electronic payment methods is considered to be adequate. So, what is macro electronic payment systems? Macro electronic payment system is an online payment system designed to allow efficient and frequent payments of higher amounts. So, if you want to do higher amounts of transactions, you have to use macro electronic payment systems. Okay. The security requirements are more rigorous in macro payment systems because of huge money transactions. Some of the popular macro online payment systems are card-based payment systems, electronic account transfer, electronic cash payment systems, mobile payment systems, and internet payment systems. Let us discuss them one by one. Okay, first let us see about card-based payment systems. Payment cards are plastic cards that enable cashless payments. They are simple embossed plastic card that authenticates the card holder on behalf of card issuing the company, which allows the user to make the use of various financial services. Based on the transaction settlement method, there are three widely used card payment systems. What are they? Credit card based payment systems, which means pay later. Debit card based payment systems, which means pay now. Stored value card payment systems, which means pay before. So first let us see credit card based payment systems. Credit card is an electronic payment system normally used for retail transactions. So it is used for retail transactions. A credit card enables the buyer to buy goods or services from the seller based on the card holder's promise to the card issuer to pay back the value later with an agreed interest. Okay. See this picture. This is the credit card front page. This is the back page. Here this one is the bank name. Here this two is credit card number. Okay. This is modern credit number. It is a 16 digit unique identification number. Next three is the name of the card holder, which means username. Okay. And the next fourth one is EMV chip. This is integrated chip. Card holder's information is stored in this chip. EMV stands for Europay Mastercard Visa. Okay, Europay Mastercard Visa. These three names correspond to the names of the companies which are responsible to develop this technology. Next, fifth one is RFID symbol. This is the RFID symbol. It is four curved lines radiating rightwards, similar to a tilted Wi-Fi symbol. It looks like Wi-Fi symbol. Okay. It indicates that it is a contactless smart card. Okay. Next, sixth is the expiration month and year. Here, valid expiration month and year is given. Okay. It is visible on the front side. The card is valid until the last day of the month printed on it. Okay. Next, card brand logo. So, seventh one is what? Logo. It is the name of the credit card network company. Visa and MasterCard are leading credit card network companies. Eighth one is magnetic strip. It is an iron-based magnetic material containing encrypted data about the card holder and account number. Next, ninth one is hologram. This hologram is a security feature that prevents duplication. It is a three-dimensional image formed by interference of light beams. Next, tenth one is signature. It is a card holder's signature at the back of the card, used as an attempt to identify card holder's identity. It also holds the last four digits of card number. Okay. Next, 11th one is CVC or CVV, which means card verification code. Okay, card verification code, CVC. This value is a three digit code usually printed to the left of the signature pan, validates the card. Next, let us see advantages of credit card. First advantage is most credit cards are accepted worldwide. Next one is it is not necessary to pay physical money at the time of purchase. The customer gets extra period to pay the purchase. Because using credit card, you can pay the money later. Okay. Next, depending on the card, there is no need to pay annuity. Next, allows purchases over the internet in installments. Next, some issues allows round up the purchase price and pay the difference in cash to make transactions easy. These are the advantages of credit card. Next, let us see key players in operations of credit card. These are the key players in credit card. Card holder, merchant, acquirer, credit card network, issuing bank. The card holder pays the merchant for a purchase with a credit card. The merchant sends the credit card details to the acquirer. The acquirer forwards that credit card details to the credit card network. The credit card network requests payment authorization from the issuing bank. Okay, next one is debit card. What is debit card? Debit card is an electronic payment card where the transaction amount is deducted directly from the cardholder's bank account upon authorization. Currently, there are three ways of processing debit card transactions. What are they? EFT POS. It is also known as online debit or PIN debit. Okay. Next, offline debit. It is also known as signature debit. Next one is electronic purse card system. Okay. These are the three ways of processing debit card transactions. Okay. Next one is stored value cards. Stored value card is a type of debit card that is preloaded with a certain amount with which a payment is made. It is a card that has default monetary value onto it. This card may be disposed when the value is used or recharged to use it again. Its major advantage is customers don't need to have a bank account to get prepaid cards. There are two varieties for stored value card. What are they? Closed loop and open loop. In closed loop cards, money is metaphorically stored on the card in the form of binary coded data. Closed loop cards are issued by the specific merchant and can only be used to make purchases from the specific place. The example of closed loop card is Chennai Metro Rail Travel Card. What is open loop cards? Open loop cards can be used to make debit transaction at a variety of retailers. It is also called as prepaid debit cards. It can be used anywhere the branded cards are accepted. For example, Visa gift cards. Okay, next let us see about smart card. The modern version of card-based payment is smart cards. Smart cards, along with the regular features of any card-based payment system, holds a EMI chip. Smart cards are classified into two types. What are they? Contact smart cards and contactless smart cards. What is contact smart cards? Contact smart cards have a contact area of approximately 1 square centimeter, comprising several gold-plated contact pads. For example, a point of sale terminal. Next one is contactless smart cards. Contactless smart cards is empowered by RF induction technology. Unlike contact smart cards, these cards require only near proximity to an antenna to communicate. Next one is electronic account transfer. Apart from card-based payment systems, there are many alternative electronic payment systems. These electronic payment systems are used to do the international transactions. These includes ECS, EFT, and RTGS. ECS stands for Electronic Clearing Services, EFT stands for Electronic Fund Transfers, and RTGS stands for Real-Time Gross Settlement System. Let us discuss them one by one. First, let us see about Electronic Clearing Services, ECS. Electronic clearance service can be defined as repeated transfer of funds from one bank account to multiple bank accounts using computer or internet technology. And what do you mean by electronic fund transfer? It is the electronic transfer of money over an online network. Here, the amount sent from sender's bank branch is credited to the receiver's bank branch on the same day in batches. Next, real-time gross settlement system. It is the payment system particularly used for settlement of transactions between financial institutions, especially banks. Next topic is electronic cash payment systems. Electronic cash is a currency that flows in the form of data. It converts the cash value into a series of encrypted sequence of numbers and uses the serial numbers to represent the market value of various currencies in reality. What is cryptocurrency? A cryptocurrency is a unique virtual asset designed to work as a medium of exchange using cryptographic algorithm. This algorithm secures the transaction by recording it in blockchain, and it controls the creation of additional units of currency. So we can call it as crypto coins, e-cash, or alternative currencies, virtual currencies. So this cryptocurrency is also called as crypto coins, e-cash, alternative currencies, or virtual currencies. What is Bitcoin? Bitcoin is the most popular and first decentralized cryptocurrency. Bitcoin payment system was developed in 2009. Bitcoin is the most popular cryptocurrency. But there are many other cryptocurrencies which are referred to as altcoins. So what is altcoins? Altcoins is collective name for all cryptocurrencies that appeared after Bitcoin. The early altcoins, Litecoin and Namecoin, appeared in 2011. Next, what is mining? The cryptocurrency unit are created by the solution of cryptographic task that is called mining. So the cryptocurrency unit are created by the solution of cryptographic task are called what? Mining. The miners not only generate new monetary units but also initiate new transaction to the blockchain. Okay, what is blockchain? Blockchains are open distributed book that records transaction of cryptocurrencies between any two parties in an efficient and verifiable manner. It is a continuously growing list of records called blocks, which are linked to each other and protected using encryption algorithm. So what is blockchain? Blockchains are the open distributed book that records transactions of cryptocurrencies between any two parties. Okay. Next one is electronic wallets. Electronic wallets is also called as electronic purses. It allows users to make electronic transactions quickly and securely over the internet through smartphones or computer. The electronic wallet functions almost the same as a physical wallet in term that holds our money. So if you want to do electronic transaction quickly and securely over the internet, you can use electronic wallets. Okay, it is also known as electronic purses. Next, let us see about mobile banking and internet banking. Nowadays, we can send and receive money instantly without any plastic cards through the smartphones. For that, mobile banking and internet banking is used. So first, let us see what is mobile banking. Mobile banking is another form of net banking. It is also called as mBanking. mBanking stands for mobile banking. It refers to the services provided by the bank to the customer to conduct banking transaction with the aid of mobile phones. These transactions include balance checking, account transfers, payments, purchases, and so on. In mobile banking, transaction can be done at any time and anywhere. See this picture, mobile banking through smartphone application. If you want to transfer the fund, you have to click this option fund transfer, and here you have to select the payee account, here you have to select the payee nickname, and here you have to type the amount to be transferred, and here you have to select the account to be debited. After that, click OK button. The amount will be transferred to the particular receiver. Okay. This mobile banking operations can be implemented in many ways. Contacting the call center, automatic IVR telephone service, using a mobile phone via SMS, and using smartphone applications. Okay. Next, let us see about internet banking. Internet banking is also called as e-banking, online banking, virtual banking, direct banks, web banking, and remote banking. It operates only on the internet with no physical branches. Internet banking allows customers of a financial institution to conduct various financial transactions on a secure website operated by banking institutions. This is a very fast and convenient way of performing any banking transactions. It enables customers of a bank to conduct wide range of financial transactions through its website. The advantages of internet banking are the payments are made at the convenience of the account holder and are secured by the username and password. With the internet access, it can be used anywhere in the world and at any time. And next advantage is any standard browser, which means Google Chrome or Firefox, is adequate. Internet banking does not need installing any additional software. These are the advantages of internet banking. Next, the steps to transfer fund using net banking. First step is, you have to log in the net banking account using unique username and password provided by the bank earlier. Next, add the pay details to transfer the fund, which means account number, name, IFSC code. Okay, for that you have to click add new payee option. Okay, after that choose RTGS or NEFT or IMPS mode to fund transfer. Next, select the account to transfer money from. Select the payee, enter the amount to be transferred and add remarks. It is optional. After that, click on submit button. Next step is, enter the OTP received to the mobile number linked to the corresponding account to complete the transaction. So these are the steps to transfer fund using net banking. Okay. Next topic is Unified Payment Interface. Unified Payments Interface, UPI, is a real-time payment system developed by National Payment Corporations of India to facilitate interbank transactions. It is a simple, secure, and instant payment facility. This interface is regulated by the Reserve Bank of India and used for transferring funds instantly between two bank accounts through mobile platform devices. UPI applications uses two types of address. What are they? Global and local. It uses two types of address, global and local. Global address includes bank account numbers and IFSC codes. Okay. Local address is a virtual payment address. Next topic is advantages of Unified Payments Interface. First advantage is immediate money transfers through the mobile device round the clock 24/7. So you can transfer the money through mobile device by using Unified Payment Interface all the days and 24 hours. Okay. We can use single mobile application for accessing multiple bank accounts. This is the another one advantage. Next advantage is single click authentication for transferring of fund. And next advantage is it is not required to enter the details such as card number, account number, IFSC code, etc. for every transaction. You have to store the pay details such as card number, account number, IFSC code for one time. You no need to enter the details for every transaction. Okay. Electronic payments will become much easier without requiring a digital wallet or credit or debit card. These are the advantages of Unified Payments Interface. Next topic is Cash on Delivery, which means COD. Cash on Delivery is also called as Collection of Delivery, describes a mode of payment in which the payment is made only on receipt of goods rather in advance. It offers when the recipient the advantage of paying only when the product is handed over, that is slightly similar to traditional system. If the goods are not paid, they are returned to the retailer. So this is about electronic payment systems. I hope you understand. Thank you, students.